So what are we going to build? Well, we have this app where we have posts, categories, and authors. That's all set up. And we also have some really nice seeds as well where it's going to put some data into the database. So we have something which looks a bit like this. So post, categories, something to connect the posts and the categories together, and the authors. And we're going to create using ActiveAdmin a administrator panel which looks a little bit like this. And should hopefully take us not too long, so I'm pretty excited. So you might be wondering why I've picked ActiveAdmin. It mostly comes down to a strong personal preference because I've had really good experiences with it. Where one, it has super good documentation on this particular website. Like everything I've ever needed to do is pretty much somewhere here in this sidebar. The actual main repo has been kept up to date really well. Like literally 23 hours ago, it was last updated. Which I think gives me a lot of faith in the project. Plus, I've always found it's very it complements like good Rails design. So if you've got well-designed models, which maybe use decorators to kind of display themselves in a view, and everything does work, everything's got a relationship to each other the way it's meant to, it'll just work out of the box and require very little effort. But mostly, I like ActiveAdmin because I picked up a project a little while ago where someone had this custom built their admin panel, and it was just the worst experience I've ever had. And it's made me kind of come running back to like the nice DSL you get on here. So we're going to start by installing ActiveAdmin. So we're going to use Devise and ActiveAdmin. So Devise is kind of a go-to user authorization gem, which is really popular, and ActiveAdmin is ActiveAdmin. So we're going to put those both in our gem file. We're going to run bundle. Cool. We're now going to run the Devise install generator script, which is just going to add the configuration file and a YAML, like these two here. Cool. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to do Rails generate ActiveAdmin install use Webpacker. And this is just like the ActiveAdmin install stuff. You can find it on the README. But this is just going to go through, it's going to create an admin user, it's going to create some routes, and it's going to create some seeds. So that's pretty sweet. So while that kind of does its thing, let's kind of have a look. So it's created a admin user model right here. That's pretty cool. I have a strong preference of just using a dedicated admin user model for my admin panels over this maybe a user, because it kind of separates the concerns quite nicely. I've worked on a few projects where they had users who would can navigate the site, and if you make them an admin, suddenly they get a load of links everywhere, and it always felt a bit complicated. Let's have another look at some of the stuff it's done. So if we go to the routes, you can see it set itself up there. Some magic there. If we go to the migrations, we can see it's created a migration for that admin user and a cool comment thing, which is quite neat, and I'll show you that in just a moment. One of the really important things to note is it does also add a seed for your admin. What I normally do is put a folder called seeds and load them up. But for now, what we're going to do is we're going to create that admin by doing a Rails db migrate and Rails db seed, and let that run. And we're going to log in with that user. Okay, we got that. Awesome. I think we might have to restart the server as well. The reason for that is we've created a lot of initializer files and stuff. And generally, once you've moved those around a bunch, it's just a good shout just to turn your server on and off. Cool, it's done. What we're going to do is we're going to go to admin and we're going to log in and we're going to see what we've got. So, out of the box, we have an empty dashboard, a place to manage our admin users, and a place to manage those comments. So, these comments, you can add comments onto like anything, and that's kind of nice for internal notes. If you imagine if you used ActiveAdmin as a support tool, you could add like notes onto a particular user saying, "Hey, they've called, and this was their problem, and this is how we solved it." If we quickly go through, and look here, this is where it made these files. So it didn't make anything for the models. We had to do explicitly add stuff, or we will have to explicitly add stuff, which is quite cool. But that's how you kind of install ActiveAdmin.